Dear students, our next chapter is chapter 7, indices. So, first of all, we will study about some of its laws. Let's see if m is a positive integer and a is any number and it is written a into a into a up to m terms, a is multiplied. Then this multiplication up to n terms of a can be written as a raised to the power m, where a is the base and m is the power. Power is also called as exponents or index. So if any number is written, suppose we have taken 2, 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 in this way, then it can be written as 2 raised to the power 4 here. If 2 is multiplied 4 times, then it can be written as 2 raised to the power 4. So here 2 is the base and 4 is the exponent or index or power, we can say. Now there are certain laws of indices. Certain laws of indices are, first is product law. Now what does this product law says? Ki agar koi bhi do terms jinko hum multiply kar rahe hain, they are such that their bases are same and their powers are different, and these two terms are multiplied with each other, then in this case base will remain same and their powers will be added. So here a raised to the power m into a raised to the power n, this can be written as a raised to the power m plus n. So when this product law is applicable, ये प्रोडक्ट लॉ तब एप्लीकेबल होता है जब दो टर्म्स का बेस सेम होता है एंड दीज टू टर्म्स आर कनेक्टेड विद द साइन ऑफ मल्टीप्लिकेशन. व्हेन दीज टू टर्म्स आर मल्टीप्लाइड विद ईच अदर, देन द बेस विल रिमेन सेम एंड द पावर्स विल बी एडेड. लेट्स सी वन एग्जांपल हियर. ए रेज्ड टू द पावर 7 इनटू ए रेज्ड टू द पावर 4. सो इन बोथ द केसेस यू कैन सी इन बोथ द टर्म्स देयर बेसिस आर सेम, दैट इज ए, and there these two terms are multiplied with each other. So here base will remain a only and the powers will be added. So a raised to the power 7 plus 4, that is a raised to the power 11. Second law is quotient law. Quotient law says that if two terms are written in such a way, means when two terms are divided, when one term is divided by the other term in such a way that their bases are same and powers are different here. So in this case, the base will remain same and power will be subtracted. Numerator ki power mein se denominator ki power ko minus kar denge. So here a raised to the power m is the numerator and the denominator is a raised to the power n. Dono ka base same hai. Isiliye jo answer aayega wo kya aayega? Base will remain same only a and power will be m minus n. A raised to the power m minus n. Let's take for example a raised to the power 7 divided by a raised to the power 4. So it is equal to a raised to the power 7 minus 4. Subtraction of power will occur because division is occurring here and both the terms are having same base, that is a. So a raised to the power 7 minus 4, that is equal to a raised to the power 3. Then the third law is power law. Power law says that a raised to the power m, कि होल पावर n, a रेज़ टू द पावर n एक टर्म है, इस टर्म की पावर क्या है, n है, देन इन सच केस दीज टू पावर्स विल बी मल्टीप्लाइड एंड बेस विल रिमेन a ओनली. सो a रेज़ टू द पावर m टू द होल पावर n इज इक्वल टू a रेज़ टू द पावर m इनटू n, दैट इज mn. फॉर एग्जांपल a रेज़ टू द पावर 3 टू द होल पावर 4, देन व्हाट वी विल गेट, these two powers will be multiplied and base will remain a only, that is equal to a raised to the power 12. 3 4s are 12. So these are some laws of indices which we have to apply in our exercises. Now let's see some more properties of indices. First is a into b raised to the whole power m. So it can be written as, now see here a and b both are connected with the sign of multiplication and this power m is given outside the bracket. It means that this power is of A also and of B also. So it can be written as A raised to the power m into B raised to the power m separately, because this power is given outside the bracket, it is for both the terms. In the same way, A upon B raised to the whole power m, here also this power is given outside the bracket, it means that this power is of negative, this power is of numerator also and of denominator also. So it can be written as A raised to the power m upon B raised to the power m separately. Second one is, if A is not equal to 0, A कोई एक ऐसा नंबर है जो कि 0 नहीं है, and n is a positive integer, और n कोई एक पॉजिटिव इंटीजर है, then nth root of A is equal to A raised to the power 1 upon n. कहीं पे भी अगर इस तरीके से दे रखा है nth root of A, where A is not equal to 0 and n is a positive integer, then what we, then how we can write it without square, without applying this root. इस root को लगाए बिना हम इस चीज को इस तरीके से भी लिख सकते हैं, this is equal to A raised to the power 1 upon n. ये जो n है वो denominator में आ जाएगा यहाँ पे, and power will become 1 upon n. Example you can see, if it is given cube root of A, so here 3 is a positive integer and A is not equal to 0, therefore it can be written as A raised to the power 1 upon 3 according to this formula. In the same way, 8th root of A can be written as A, base will come A only and power will be 1 upon 8. Then third property is A raised to the power m upon n, it is equal to n root A raised to the power m. अगर कहीं पे भी इस तरीके से दे रखा है कोई term, then it can be written in the form of root as n, denominator will come out which will represent the root, nth root cube, nth root मतलब is square root होगा, cube root होगा, जो भी होगा, it will depend on the value of n. So A raised to the power m upon n can be written as n root A and numerator will come inside, A raised to the power m, where A is also not equal to 0. For example, you can see here, it is given A raised to the power 4 upon 5. Now this term in the form of root can be written as, this denominator will come outside, because in place of n what is given, 5, so 5 root, base is A only, so A will come, and numerator is 4, so 5 root A raised to the power 4. Conversely, अगर ये चीज़ें रखी होती तो इसको हम इस तरीके से भी लिख सकते थे. So if A raised to the power m upon n is given, then it can be written as n root A raised to the power m, and if it is given n root A raised to the power m, then it can be written as that to A to the power m upon n. दोनों तरीके से property valid है. Next one is, for any non-zero number, कोई भी एक नॉन जीरो नंबर है, a, a is not equal to 0, इसकी पावर अगर n दे रखी है, a raised to the power n, तो इस तरीके के टर्म का जब हम रेसिप्रोकल करते हैं तो जो पावर होती है उसकी, उसका साइन चेंज हो जाता है. Here a raised to the power n is given, n is a positive integer here, so on taking the reciprocal of this term, what we will get, 1 upon a, what I have told, that the sign of the power will change, so it will become 1 upon a raised to the power minus n, because here it was positive, so on taking the reciprocal, it will become, power will become negative. If the term is given such that the power is already negative, तो अब हम इस तरीके के टर्म का जब रेसिप्रोकल लेंगे तो अब इसका साइन चेंज होकर क्या हो जाएगा, पॉजिटिव, पॉजिटिव विल बिकम नेगेटिव एंड नेगेटिव विल बिकम पॉजिटिव. सो a रेज टू द पावर माइनस n कैन बी रिटन एज 1 अपॉन a टू द पावर n, ऑन टेकिंग द रेसिप्रोकल पावर, साइन ऑफ द पावर विल चेंज. एग्जांपल, a टू द पावर 3, a रेज टू द पावर 3 कैन बी रिटन एज 1 अपॉन a raised to the power minus 3, sign is changing here. In the same way, a raised to the power minus 7 can be written as 1 upon a raised to the power 7, because it was already negative, so on doing the reciprocal, sign will change, it will become positive. Next, last property is, for any non-zero number, कोई भी non-zero number है, अगर उस नंबर की पावर जीरो है, फॉर एनी नॉन जीरो नंबर विच इज रेज टू द पावर जीरो, देन इट्स वैल्यू इज इक्वल टू वन. दैट इज ए रेज टू द पावर जीरो इज इक्वल टू वन, हियर ए इज नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो. इन द सेम वे फाइव रेज टू द पावर जीरो विल बी इक्वल टू वन. सो दीज आर द सम प्रॉपर्टीज.